Let's speak now to Sami Hamdi, who joins us from London. He is the editor of The International Interest. Thanks so much for speaking to us, Hamdi. In your opinion, do you think justice is actually closing in on Saudi leadership now, or is there still a way for particularly Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman to distance himself far enough to avoid real responsibility here?
I think Mohammed bin Salman certainly believes that there is a possibility for him to distance himself from the killing of Jamal Khashoggi. We now see him praising Turkey, praising the Qatar economy. We now see him meeting Khashoggi's sons to express condolences. We see him sitting in front of the World Forum talking about how it was a heinous crime what happened to Jamal Khashoggi, and that it is important to bring those who committed the crime to account. We see him now talking about how he is exerting as much effort as possible in order to bring justice for the case of Jamal Khashoggi. This recent PR campaign from Mohammed bin Salman suggests that he is now creating maneuvers and space between him and the actual act. And I think that given in the past where we've seen the U.S. seek to defend Mohammed bin Salman, seek to defend Saudi Arabia, come up with excuses for Saudi Arabia before it's even happened, given that Gina Haspel traveled to Ankara before Erdogan's speech where he was supposed to reveal the naked truth, I think that there are efforts now in order to try to create distance between Mohammed bin Salman and between this case. So I don't think we're on the verge of justice. I think we're in another phase in which Mohammed bin Salman is trying to distance himself from this, and we are yet to see whether this will succeed or not.
Okay, so clarify then what you make of the Turkish approach. We just heard President Erdogan say that Turkey does have evidence, but there's no need to be hasty right now in releasing every bit of it. And he is instead demanding direct answers from Saudi.
I think with Turkey, I think one of the biggest issues that Turkey has at the moment is the lack of international support in order to pursue justice for Jamal Khashoggi. I say this because even though Europe has come out with statements condemning Jamal Khashoggi, there has not actually been a request for an international investigation into what happened, despite the fact that Turkish Foreign Minister Çavuşoğlu actually said that if there is a request for an international investigation, we are happy to cooperate. Instead, Turkey has seen the U.S. go to great pains to defend Saudi Arabia, to defend Mohammed bin Salman. Turkey has seen Russia and China take a back step, not willing to criticize Saudi Arabia, and even Russia suggesting some sort of defense for Saudi Arabia. I think the biggest issue for Turkey is this. If it was to really pursue Jamal Khashoggi on its own, would it receive this international support, or would the U.S. finally decide to go hard, go and defend Mohammed bin Salman because he is a valuable ally? Let's remember that Mohammed bin Salman, according to the Pentagon, according to the White House, is a fundamental ally against Iran, is a fundamental ally against the religious authorities in Saudi Arabia, and a key ally in bringing liberalism to Saudi Arabia, which is what they're really keen on. So I think the fault lies not with Turkey that there is a delay in bringing out this evidence into the public sphere. The real problem that Turkey has right now is simply that it wants to reveal who committed this murder. Whether because it is because of justice or whether it is because they want to get rid of Mohammed bin Salman is irrelevant here. The reality is that President Erdogan and Turkey are very keen to get to the bottom of what happened. The problem is, however, is even if they release the evidence, even if they try to get to the bottom of it, can they expect the international community to implement any of the findings, to support Turkey in any of the findings, or will they seek to create a narrative of Turkey going after Saudi Arabia? This is the real issue. Okay. Turkey at this moment in time is adopting a policy of let's keep dripping until we see what circumstances develop in front of us.
Is it then kind of farcical for you that Saudi is showcasing, you know, an independent judiciary of sorts by sending a prosecutor and by having its attorney general announce that, oh yes, we've now concluded that this murder was premeditated, even though the top leadership has denied it all along? I mean, how much can the results of an independent investigation out of Saudi and judgment from within Saudi be seen as, you know, autonomous?
It can be seen as autonomous. It's a joke. Mohammed bin Salman, the accused, has put himself at the head of the committee that is going to look at the case and restructure the intelligence committee. He sacked everybody around him, and it seems that if his right-hand man was involved in it, then it's impossible that Mohammed bin Salman could not have known about what happened. I think it's a joke what the Saudis are coming up with. But I think given this age we live in where somebody like Donald Trump can actually arrive in the White House, jokes can go on for quite a long time. Mm-hmm. I think it is definitely very farcical. I think it's even more farcical that a kingdom that can imprison Abdulaziz al-Tarifi, Salman al-Uda, Suleiman al-Dawish, all of these other critics within the kingdom, Suleiman al-Dawish, according to Amnesty, is believed to have been killed under torture. This is a kingdom that has put its whole opposition behind bars. So I think it's really farcical that a nation that can imprison somebody because of a Twitter, because of a tweet regarding reconciliation between Qatar and Saudi Arabia, or a tweet criticizing the sale of Aramco, or a tweet criticizing the overbearing nature of Mohammed bin Salman. I think Saudi Arabia is not a credible party at all to conduct this investigation. But because of this, because Saudi Arabia is being allowed to conduct it, this shows just how much Turkey is worried that the international community is not really behind it in pursuing justice for Jamal Khashoggi.
Okay, Sami Hamdi, we're going to have to leave it there. Thank you for that. Live from London.